DTO projections provide better performance than entities if you only want to read but not change the retrieved information. They avoid the management overhead of an entity class and enable you to only select the database columns your business code needs. But as so often, DTO projections also have a downside, and that's the handling of associations. When you select an entity object, you can easily traverse all of its managed associations. Doing that with the DTO projection requires a custom resite mapping. The JPA specification defines a constructor expression for JPQL queries, which gets executed for each record in the resite set and doesn't support nested constructor calls. That's more than good enough to map your query resite to a flat data structure. But you can't map a query resite that consists of multiple records to a DTO object that contains a list of other complex objects. This video will show you the best way to map such a query resite programmatically and how to use Hibernate's resite transformer to let Hibernate handle the resite. And I'll add links to further resources about DTO projections, association mappings, and JPQL to the video description. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. If you want to build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring Data JPA, please subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. The most obvious solution to avoid the described shortcomings of JPA's constructor expressions is to write your own mapping using Java's Stream API. That's a good approach if you need that mapping only for one query. The two main benefits of a DTO projection are that you avoid the management overhead of an entity projection and only select the database columns you need in your business code. If you map the query resite yourself, you need to ensure that you keep these benefits. That requires you to use a Scalar value projection and not an entity projection. You can retrieve a Scalar value projection as an object array or tuple interface. The tuple interface supports alias-based access to its elements and is my preferred representation of a Scalar projection. I use it in the following code sample to get the result as a stream of tuples. The main challenge of the mapping code is to only instantiate one chess tournament DTO object for each tournament ID and add all associated chess game DTO objects to its set of games. I store all chess tournament DTO objects in the chess tournament DTO map and check that map before instantiating a new object. I then create a new chess game DTO object and add it to the set of games. After the mapping is done, I remove the duplicates from the stream and collect them as a list. You can implement a similar mapping using Hibernate's resite transformer. The specific implementation of the transformer depends on your Hibernate version. In Hibernate 4 and 5, you need to implement the resite transformer interface and its transform tuple and transform list methods. In Hibernate 6, the resite transformer interface got split into the tuple transformer and the resite list transformer interface. For this mapping, you need to implement the tuple transformer interface and its transform tuple method. The method signature and your implementation of the transform tuple method are identical for all Hibernate versions. Here you can see the implementation of the resite transformer interface for Hibernate 4 and 5. I use the same algorithm in the transform tuple method as in the previous example. The transform list method ignores the transformed list of the result and uses the chess tournament DTO map to remove the duplicates from the query result. After you define your result transformer, you can assign it to your query. Hibernate will call the transform tuple method for each record in the result set and the transform list method for the entire result. You can use JPA's constructor expression and Hibernate's standard result transformer to map each record of your result set to a DTO object. But mapping the result to a more complex data structure, for example one that contains a list of other DTO objects, requires a custom mapping. You can select a Scalar value projection and map it using Java's Stream API or implement a Hibernate-specific result transformer. In both cases, your mapping code operates on the result set records. Each record includes the values of a parent DTO and a child DTO object. Within your mapping, you need to instantiate both objects and use the parent DTO object to group your result. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, make sure to visit persistencehub.com. That is my new membership that gives you access to all my premium video courses, monthly coaching calls, expert sessions, and a community of like-minded developers. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!